We are on to the last day of learning media and information literacy, and today we are expecting to learn the dangers of technology, human rights, three Philippine protections of intellectual property, the two types of rights, and then fair use. Before we start our lesson, it is always better to consider to know new terminologies. Number one, we have digital divide. Digital divide, it is the gap between those individuals who has access on internet connections to those with only limited to no access of internet. Okay? That is digital divide. The second one is netiquette. Netiquette refers to the conventions. When we say conventions, these are the accepted way of using media codes or the correct behavior in online settings. So netiquette is also known to be the good manner in online communication. Now let's move on to the dangers of technology. Number one, we have cyberbullying. Cyberbullying is harassment, insulting, and bringing other people down using the cyber world or the internet. It is just like the actual bullying done in the physical world. However, the only difference is that cyberbullying is done online. Second one, we have cybercrime. Cybercrime, these are punishable by laws, and some examples are hacking, identity theft, cybersex, and illegal access to data. For the third danger of technology, we have internet addiction. Internet addiction is the uncontrolled dependency on computer or internet use. So this is very relevant in our age because most of the youth, they cannot bring their phone down and do anything else. Okay? Then number four, copyright infringement. Copyright infringement is the misuse of copyright-protected material without any permission. Okay? Next, we're going to talk about human rights. Human rights is the right to protect one's intellectual property and also the benefits that the owner can get from that material that they own. Now let us talk about and differentiate the two, property rights and intellectual property. Property rights, these are legal ownership of tangible properties. Okay, it falls under the legal aspect, meaning to say it has something to do with the law. And in compliance in this conformity about property rights may lead to conviction, may lead to punishment given by law. Okay? One example is the marriage certificate. So that is a legal paper that can be used against your partner if ever their problems will arise. The second one, we have intellectual property. This includes intangible creation of the minds. Meaning to say, this does not have conformity or kasunduan, and these are intangible. You cannot touch it. Okay? So everything that our mind created, so these are abstract. Now let's talk about the three Philippine protections. So number one, we have the Anti-Camcording Act of 2010. So it prohibits the use of camera in some occasion. For example, you went to cinema and then you decided to record the film. So that is not a good idea because it will fall under this one, Anti-Camcording Act of 2010. Next, we have the Media and Television Review and Classifications, MTRCB. Okay? Media and Television Review and Classification Board, it provides warning on the content of the television. Then lastly, we have the Optical Media Board. So it has something to do with the protection of intellectual property against piracy. It talks about piracy and also the distribution of a material. As indicated here, no piracy. Now let's talk about the two types of rights. Number one, we have economic rights, and then number two, we have moral rights. Economic rights are the rights of the owner to be compensated upon permission for the use of work. So these are the rights of author to be properly compensated financially. When we say financially, it has something to do with remuneration. Remuneration is the money paid for the work or service. Number two, we have moral rights. Moral rights are the rights to non-economic interests of the author. So in moral rights, it has no money involved. Next, we have fair use. Fair use is the principle in copyright law that provides us with limited ability to use a copyright material. So fair use, you can do this one when you are putting up content that is non-profit, educational purposes, criticisms, parody, and research works. So you can do fair use by giving credits to the rightful owners since you are using their work for your personal intentions.